it's winter time, so the trees don't have any leaves at the moment. So it's a nice opportunity to take a look at trees with thorns and spines. And I'll explain you what the difference between the thorn and the spine is. This is a maclura, which has thorns, and that means that the veins of the thorn itself are always connected with the branch itself. And that's also the case with the gleditia, for example. And a spine, like a raspberry or a rose, is not connected with the veins inside of the branch. We're going to take a look at some different ones in the nursery, so let's go. A very nice small tree called Crataegus personalis splendens, and in English, broad-leaved cockspur. Well, you can see the spurs of the cock on every branch. They're brownish red and very sharp and very long. So it's also a tree good against vandalism. You wouldn't climb in such a tree or break down its branches. It can also be used to make a small avenue. It has a white standing flower in May that attracts a lot of bumblebees and bees. And it's also good for birds, because in autumn you get red fruits on it that birds like to eat. Doesn't get too big, about 8 meters in height, and it can also withstand a lot of drought. So a quite resilient, strong tree. Crataegus personalis splendens. And again, we have a very prickly shrub here, in this case Xanthoxylum simulans. And in English, flat spine prickly ash, because the leaves look a bit like an ash leaf. And here you can see the thorns on the branches. They're quite flat. And then there's also big thorns on the stem itself. And the whole tree is covered in it. You can grow it either as a shrub or as a small tree on the trunk. And then it's not only prickly on the outside, but also on the inside. These are the fruits. They were nice and red in autumn. And now the fruits itself have fallen out. And then the shell consists on the tree. And in China, they use this to make Sichuan pepper. The whole Sichuan area is called after this pepper. If you put it in your mouth, it gives a, yeah, prickly, sour taste in your mouth, and you can use it in a lot of dishes instead of normal pepper. So it's a very special tree. Xanthoxylum doesn't require any special soils. It's an easy tree to grow. It spreads out a lot, gets 3 to 5 meters in height and spread. A very nice tree to consider, Xanthoxylum simulans. We're looking at a very special tree here called Maclura pomifera. And in English it's called the Osage Orange or Hedge Apple. This tree originates from the southwestern part from the United States. In the times of the Wild West, before the invention of barbed wire, this tree was planted as a hedgerow to keep cattle inside. And I can assure you, there's no bull running through these thorns here. The name Osage comes from the Osage Indians that used the wood to make bows from. It's a very strong tree that grows up to 10-15 meters in height. It's also a tree that can stand high pH salts, low pH salts, dry, wet circumstances, heat, cold. Very, very strong, healthy tree. It also gets these fruits. The trees consist of male and female trees, and this is what grows on the female tree. You cannot eat it, but it looks like a big yellow brain structure, like orange, and the fruits appear also in our climate here. So very nice tree to keep in mind. It needs a lot of space, but it's something really different. Maclura pomifera. Here we have a tree that you don't see very often. It's called Calopanax septemlobus, and in English it's called Castor aurelia. It has a lot of spines on the trunk and on the young branches here. The tree originates from the eastern part of Russia, the part called Sakhalin, the part where North Korea is. And it's very, very cold resistant. It can easily withstand temperatures under minus 25 Celsius. It's quite a strong tree. It can grow up to 20 meters in height and spread. You wouldn't say it if you see the tree at this stage. And it can stand on a lot of different soil types. It's quite strong and it's also very good to stand in the full sun. Nice name to remember, Calopanax septemlobus. This is Robinia pseudoacacia nersegii, and nersegii refers to an area in Hungary, Nersegi, where this tree was discovered. And it's always used as a forestry tree there because it has a tendency to grow quite straight and it doesn't form a lot of knots in the wood. So for a nurseryman it's an easy tree to grow. It's a nice straight tree that can grow up to 20-25 meters in height, and it's totally covered in thorns, also the young branches and also on the stem. It can get thorns up to 3 centimeters approximately. It's very drought resistant and it can be used in industrial areas, also street salt resistant. It's a quite versatile, strong tree, which needs quite some space underneath. But then you have a very healthy tree, Robinia pseudoacacia nersegii. Thanks for watching our vlog. Do you want to widen your horizon about trees? Then subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next time. Bye bye.